Yes, we will continue our biology class. We have discussed about adrenal gland. I told you adrenal gland contains two endocrine parts. One is adrenal cortex, another one is adrenal medulla. So both are structurally and functionally different. It has got different cells. They secrete different hormones. Now let's take adrenal cortex alone. See, adrenal cortex, it has got three areas, three zones. The major part is the first zone. It is followed by the middle zone, then the innermost zone. These are the three areas. That three areas are named as zona glomerulosa. Zona glomerulosa. It is the outermost part of the adrenal cortex. And the middle part of the adrenal cortex is zona reticularis, zona fasciculata. See, the middle part is called zona fasciculata. Zona fasciculata. The innermost network of blood capillary areas are there. That is called zona reticularis. Reticularis. So these are the three areas of adrenal cortex. So structurally, it composed of three areas: zona glomerulosa, fasciculata, reticularis. See here, zona glomerulosa act as a single unit, and they secrete hormone called mineralocorticoid hormone. Mineralocorticoid hormone. That we will see in the slides. Mineralocorticoid hormone. Corticoids. See, corticoids. The major mineralocorticoid hormones are aldosterone. We are going to see the functions of aldosterone. Right. Zona fasciculata and zona reticularis together as a single unit. They secrete a hormone called glucocorticoid hormone. Glucocorticoids. This glucocorticoid hormone, major hormone is cortisone and corticosteroid hormone. So these are the adrenal cortex. So mineralocorticoid hormone, glucocorticoid hormone secreted adrenal cortex. In which part it is secreted? Zona glomerulosa, zona fasciculata. Glomerulosa secrete mineralocorticoid hormone. Fasciculata secrete glucocorticoid hormone. So here reticularis also act as a the zona fasciculata, and they secrete hormone called glucocorticoids. Now let's see the functions of each and every hormone. Right, let's see in the slide. Adrenal medulla act as a separate unit that we will discuss later. First, adrenal cortex. See next slide. This is adrenal gland located above the kidney, two distinct area, adrenal cortex and medulla. Then this is followed by somebody is marking unnecessarily. So please avoid marking in your laptop or other things. Right. So this is the structure we have discussed. This is the diagram for adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. Then the diagram already I have drawn in the board. Right, this is adrenal cortex. I told you three layers: zona glomerulosa, zona fasciculata, zona reticularis. And the hormone secreted from adrenal cortex are glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid hormones. So these are the two hormones. See, the glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid hormones. Here, glucocorticoid hormone, the major glucocorticoid hormones are cortisol and corticosterone. Cortisol and corticosterone. See, cortisol is an anti-inflammatory and anti-allergic agent. Very important one more question. Which is called anti-inflammatory and anti-allergic agent. not the soul. Right. It is secreted by zona fasciculata, I told you. It regulates carbohydrate, protein and fat metabolism. It stimulates the formation of glucose from glycogen in the liver. Its function is similar to that of glucagon hormone. Here, another one more question. Which hormone is synergistic to glucagon hormone? When they ask this question, you are supposed to write glucocorticoid hormone, cortisol. See, the function of cortisol as well as glucagon, both are similar. They are synergistic hormone. See, insulin and glucagon are antagonistic hormone. One increases glucose level, another one reduces glucose level. So they are called antagonistic hormone. Whereas here, cortisol or glucocorticoid hormone as well as glucagon are synergistic hormone. In that way, they will ask question in the third point. Right, the last point I told you, it is an anti-inflammatory agent, anti-allergic agent. So these substances, you know, they reduces, inflammation of our skin. If there is any injury, any bacterial infection or viral infection in the wound, what happened? It reduces the growth of microorganisms. It reduces the swelling of tissues. That is why it is called anti-inflammatory agents. So the antibiotic substances or any ointment which is used for applying on the wound may contain these substances. Right. Now let's see the functions of mineralocorticoid hormone. Next, mineralocorticoid hormone. The mineralocorticoid hormones are secreted by zona glomerulosa. Zona glomerulosa. It helps to reabsorb sodium ion from the renal tubule. Now their function is oriented to uniferous tubule. See, the major mineralocorticoid hormone is aldosterone. Aldosterone. Now its function, the name itself, it has got its meaning. See, mineralocorticoid regulate mineral absorption of sodium from uriniferous tubule in the nephron. It causes increased excretion of potassium ion, regulate electrolyte balance, body fluid volume, osmotic pressure and blood pressure. In our body, it regulates intra and extracellular fluid volume, osmotic balance, blood pressure. That is regulated by mineralocorticoid hormone. See, the major mineralocorticoid hormone is aldosterone. So these are the two major hormones secreted from adrenal cortex. If a hormone secreted less or low, it will lead some kind of problem. Say for example, less secretion of adrenal cortex hormone may lead to the condition called Addison's disease. Person who are having Addison's disease may have hyperpigmentation on their skin. More melanin pigment is distributed on their skin. And this is a kind of problem in which the face which is exposed to sunlight or neck or the part of the body which is exposed to sunlight may have overpigmentation. That is the symptoms of Addison's disease. Suppose this hormone, when it is secreted enormous amount, hyper secretion of adrenal cortex may lead to the condition called Cushing's syndrome. Cushing's syndrome. You know, the Cushing's syndrome is nothing but it is the condition called virulism in male, virulism in female, gynecomastia in male. See, gynecomastia and virulism. Virulism in the sense that appearance of male character in female, development of beard and moustache in female. That means auntie become uncles. So this is called virulism, appearance of male characters. Gynecomastia means development of breast in male. That is called gynecomastia. So these are all hypersecretion of adrenal cortex hormone. Why these secondary sexual character differ in both male and female in the sense that along with this mineralocorticoid hormone, some amount of estrogen, some amount of testosterone hormone also secreted. So when it is secreted more, these kinds of virulism and Cushing's syndrome, I mean kind of a mastia will occur. So that is the disorders related to glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid hormone. Right. Now let's see the adrenal medulla. So far we have discussed about adrenal cortex. It is separated into endocrine gland. Now adrenal medulla. The adrenal medulla composed of chromaffin cells. It is richly supplied with the sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. You know, the nervous parasympathetic and sympathetic nerve comes under autonomous nervous system. It is supplying the adrenal medulla. Right. It secretes two hormones, epinephrine, norepinephrine. Epinephrine is also called adrenaline. Norepinephrine is also called noradrenaline. So adrenaline and noradrenaline are the hormones secreted from adrenal medulla. Now these hormones together called emergency hormone. Very important question. Which is called emergency hormone? Adrenaline hormone is also called emergency hormone. Adrenaline or noradrenaline? Epinephrine or norepinephrine? So these hormones are called emergency hormone. Why they are called emergency hormone? They are produced during the conditions of stress and emotions. Hence, it is also known as flight, fright, fight hormone. So, adrenal gland is also denoted as glands of flight, fright, fight. Why? It is secreted at the time of stress. It is secreted at the time of happiest occasion. It is secreted at the time of frightness. So, kobam, bayam, sanda podum bodhu secrete aagakoodiya hormones idha adrenaline, noradrenaline. Anala indha flight, fright, fight hormone. Adrenaline hormone is also called flight, fright, fight hormone. Appdin solla emergency hormone. So, this is very important. One more question. So this is adrenal medulla, I told you. Now let's see the functions of these hormones. See, adrenal medulla, epinephrine secreted from adrenal medulla. It is also called adrenaline, I told you. It promotes the conversion of glycogen into glucose in the liver and muscles. See, adrenaline also take part in the formation of glucose. Its function is similar to that of adrenal cortex hormone. Like glucocorticoid hormone, cortisone. Cortisone function and its function is similar. Three hormone function is similar. Adrenaline, cortisone and glucagon. These three hormones have the same function in which it converts glycogen into glucose. Right. Next one, it increases heartbeat rate and blood pressure. So during emergency condition, suppose we are in the situation of fright, flight, fight. What happened? It increases our heartbeat rate. It increases the rate of respiration also by dilation of bronchi and trachea. So increases the rate of respiration. We can breathe more. We can breathe more amount of oxygen. So oxygen has to be supplied in enormous amount to cells. And its another role is to cause the dilation of people in the eye. So when we are in anger, we are fighting with one another in the sense, say that what happened, our pupil will dilate. And the next function, it decreases blood flow through skin. So certain organ receive less amount of blood and some of the organ in our body receive enormous amount of blood. Muscles get more amount of blood, whereas digestive system, kidney, these are all receive less amount of blood. So it increases blood supply through the skin. Right? These are all the functions of adrenaline. In certain occasions, what happened? It causes contraction of rectus muscles so that our hairs on skin will stand on end. That is called goose flesh of hair. So that goose flesh of hair is also due to adrenaline hormone. So these hormones are secreted during fight, fright, flight. So it is called a flight, fright, fight hormones. So these are the functions of adrenal in hormone. So these will be coming under four markers. Very important one. Write the physiological functions of adrenal in hormone. Next. Now the functions of norepinephrine or noradrenaline. Now its function is also similar to that of the adrenaline. Both adrenaline as well as noradrenaline have got the same role, but the noradrenaline effect is milder than that of the adrenaline hormone. So most of its action is similar to those of epinephrine. So with that, I have completed adrenal gland. So we have seen adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. So here anything will come under four markers. Given account of adrenal gland, if they ask, you are supposed to write both adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. If they ask adrenal medulla alone, you are supposed to write adrenal medulla consists of chromaffin cells. These cells secrete two hormones, adrenaline, noradrenaline. Now, what are the functions of adrenaline? Emergency hormone, flight, fright, fight hormone. So that you are supposed to write. And what are the other roles during emergency condition? That also you are supposed to write. Noradrenaline role is similar to that of adrenaline. So with that, adrenal medulla is over. So we have completed adrenal gland. Right. Now let us pass on to the next endocrine gland, ovary and testis. So both the endocrine glands are gonads. Next endocrine gland, gonads. We will discuss gonads. See, the gonads in the saying that the male reproductive and female reproductive organs, the male and female reproductive glands or organs are the gonads. They are the sex glands, we can say. There are two types of sex glands. One is testes in male and ovary in female. So these are the two glands. Now, next slide. Let's see the testes. They are the reproductive gland in male, I told you. It is composed of seminiferous tubule, Leydig cells and Sertoli cells. The Leydig cells secrete hormone. So it is the endocrine part. It secretes male sex hormone called testosterone. Now let's see the structure of testes. Now see, the testes is a male sex, male sex gland. Now you know the male reproductive system consists of a pair of testes. The testes, when you take the section of testes, you can find a number of cylindrical tube-like structure. These cylindrical tube-like structures are called seminiferous tubule. Seminiferous tubule. This seminiferous tubule plays very important role for the production of sperm. Here sperm cells are produced. Spermatogenesis will be carried out in seminiferous tubule. Now in between the seminiferous tubule, you have cells called Leydig cells. See, the space between two seminiferous tubules are called Leydig cell, Leydig, L-E-Y-D-I-G apostrophe, Leydig cells. These Leydig cells secrete hormone. This hormone is called testosterone. Testosterone. This is the male sex hormone. See, seminiferous tubule plays very important role for the production of sperm. It takes part in spermatogenesis. Whereas in between two seminiferous tubules, you can find interstitial cells, or it is also called the Leydig cells, or it is otherwise known as nurse cells. Nurse cells are called Sertoli cells, that is present just lining of the seminiferous tubule. So along with this, Leydig cells are present. So the Leydig cells are endocrine part here. It secrete hormone, male sex hormone called testosterone. Now what is the role of testosterone? That we will see in the slide. See the testosterone. Now, the functions of testosterone, I told you, see, this is, it influences the process of spermatogenesis. Now, you know, spermatogenesis is the process of formation of sperm in the seminiferous tubule. So, spermatogenesis. Right. Next, it stimulates protein synthesis and control muscular growth. In the case of male, what happened? Protein synthesis and muscular development also under the control of testosterone hormone. Now, it also responsible for the development of secondary sexual characters. You know, the secondary sexual character is nothing but, now once we attain the sexual maturity at the age of 14 or 15, what happened? There are some physical changes taking place in the body. That physical changes are the distribution of hair on the body and face, that is development of beard and moustache. Deep voice pattern. Now the voice pattern of male differ at the time of puberty. Then other changes, muscular thickness, hoarse voice, all are under the control of testosterone hormone. So testosterone hormone plays very important role for the development of secondary sexual character. Initially, it takes part in development of primary sexual character. Development of testes, penis, male reproductive organ. They are the primary sex organ in the case of male. When they attain sexual maturity at the age of 13 or 14 or 15, they develop secondary sexual character. That characters are under the control of hormone called a testosterone. So with that, I have completed male sex hormone, testosterone. So the testosterone is secreted from Leydig cell. This Leydig cell is under the control of hormone from pituitary gland. See, in the pituitary gland, what happened? Interstitial cell stimulating hormone. Its similar hormone is LH. See, LH in female. It stimulates ovulation in the case of female. That is, in male, interstitial cell stimulating hormone secreted from pituitary gland adenohyperphysis reaches into testes, stimulate Leydig cells. So that testosterone hormone is secreted. So testosterone hormone secretion is under the control of hormone from pituitary. So pituitary gland controls the secretion of hormone from testes. So testes is a transient endocrine gland. It secretes testosterone hormone. Right. So with that, testes over. Now let us pass on to ovary. Next endocrine gland, the gonad, is ovary. So ovary is also the transient endocrine gland. Transient endocrine gland, ovary. The ovary is a female reproductive gonad. See, the female reproductive gonad in the saying that, now when you see the structure of female reproductive system, you'll have two ovary, then followed by, this is fallopian tube. Fallopian tube opens into a common ear-shaped organ called uterus. An uterus opens into female reproductive passage, vagina, birth canal. Now, this is the place, it is called uterus. See, this is uterus part. This is ovary. And this one is fallopian tube. So, this is the female reproductive part. Here, when you take the section of ovary, you can find various stages of development of oocyte during different menstrual cyclic stage. Now let us imagine from first to fifth bleeding phase during that menstrual cycle. There are four phases, or there are three phases generally we can say. One is bleeding phase. From sixth day to 14th day, what happened? Follicular phase. So follicular phase. This is bleeding phase or menstrual phase, we can say. Bleeding phase. Menstrual phase. Then third phase from 15th day to 28th day is luteal phase. Luteal phase, we can see. So these are the three phases. So once a female attains sexual maturity after the age of 13 or 14, regular periodical menstrual cycle takes place in their body. once in every 28 days. So from first day to fifth day, what happened? Bleeding. Then sixth day to 14th day, so one of the germinal epithelial cells undergo growth. Now the germinal epithelial cells, these will become ovum. So the developing ovum is surrounded by many number of graafian follicle cell. See, this is graafian follicle cell. Very notable things. These cells secrete hormone, graafian follicle cell. Right. These graafian follicle cell later mature exactly on 14th day of menstrual cycle. What happened? The egg will come out. It is called ovulation. I told you previous class when we have seen the pituitary gland. I told you there. Ovulation. Ovulation is the process of release of ovum from graafian follicle cell. Right. Now, these get converted into the empty graafian follicle cell after ovulation, get converted into corpus luteum. Corpus luteum. It is during luteal phase. Then once luteal phase is completed, what happened? It get changed into the scar tissue. The scar tissue called corpus albigens. Corpus albigens. So these are the various stages of ovary. Various stages of egg development in the ovary when we observe the menstrual cycle from first day to 28th day. Right. Why we have to see all these structures? Now the graafian follicle cell, see here, it secrete hormone called estrogen. Estrogen is the female sex hormone. Now what are the functions of estrogen? That we are going to discuss. Second one, corpus luteum secrete pregnancy hormone called progesterone. Progesterone. So the progesterone is the hormone secreted by corpus luteum. The same hormone at the time of parturition secrete relaxin hormone. These are all the female sex hormone. So estrogen, progesterone and relaxin are the female sex hormone. See here, estrogen is secreted from graafian follicle cell. This graafian follicle cell is under the control of FSH hormone from pituitary. I told you in the pituitary gland, adenohypophysis secrete follicle stimulating hormone. That follicle stimulating hormone reaches to ovary. In the ovary, it takes part in oogenesis, formation of ovum. Now, inside the graafian follicle cell, you can find, see, one egg is developing. The egg undergo maturity. Now, the egg is surrounded by graafian follicle cell. That graafian follicle cell provide nourishment for the developing oocyte. And at the same time, it secrete hormone called estrogen. Estrogen is the female sex hormone. It is responsible for the primary and secondary sexual character in female. The primary and secondary sexual character, you know that. Right. That is under the control of estrogen. That we will see in this slide, what are the functions of estrogen. Right. Now, exactly on 14th day of menstrual cycle, the egg will come out from the graafian follicle cell from ovary. This is called ovulation. It is under the influence of luteinizing hormone. And after ovulation, what happened? The egg reaches into fallopian tube and it waits for fertilization. When the sperm reaches there, fertilization will be carried out. If there is no sperm, no fertilization. Now, after that, what happened? After 14th day, from 15th day onwards, here the empty graafian follicle cell get converted into yellow color mass of cells called the corpus luteum. The corpus luteum secrete hormone called progesterone. These progesterone take part in thickening of uterus, enlargement of uterus. Why it has to maintain uterus enlargement, uterus thickening, the inner wall of endometrial wall of uterus undergo thickening process. Network of blood capillaries are formed. It makes a suitable medium for the implantation of embryo. Suppose when 15th or 16th day, if fertilization takes place, the fertilized egg after 1 week, what happened? It will come down, slowly it gets implanted in the uterine wall. So for that purpose, what happened? The inner endometrial wall get a thicket for implantation of embryo. So that is the role of progesterone. So progesterone hormone plays very important role for preparation of uterus for implantation. So it is called pregnancy hormone. During pregnancy, it also take part in the formation of placenta formation. So placenta is nothing but it is the connective tissue which is used to connect fetus with that of the maternal uterus, endometrial wall. It provides nourishment and other things from mother side to fetus side. That is the role of placenta. Placenta formation is also under the control of progesterone hormone. Must explain. Right. So with that, I have completed the role of progesterone hormone. Now let's see the slide also here. One more endocrine gland. We are going to see that. So you see, this is the testosterone ovary structure. I told you here. It is the gonad located in the pelvic cavity of female abdomen. Secretes sex hormone estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen secreted from Graafian follicle cell. Corpus luteum release progesterone. Next slide. Now functions of estrogen. So very important there. Two more questions. It bring about changes that occur during puberty. Once we attain, female attain puberty, some changes will be taking place in their physical appearance. That is under the control of estrogen. Stimulate the process of oogenesis, egg formation. Stimulate the maturation of ovarian follicle in the ovary, Graafian follicle, I told you. Promote the development of secondary sexual character, development of breast in female, then high pitched voice and female characters are under the control of these hormones. Now the next functions of progesterone hormone. It is responsible for premenstrual changes. Premenstrual changes in the saying that luteal phase during menstrual cycle, I told you. During that time, the endometrial wall thickening takes place in the uterus. That is under the control of progesterone. It prepares the uterus for implantation of embryo. It maintains pregnancy, essential for the formation of placenta. So with that, I have completed the sex hormone progesterone. Now let's see the thymus gland, the last one, thymus gland. See, it is partially an endocrine gland and partially a lymphoid gland. So sometimes these gland will comes under two mark question. When you come for 12th standard, you will have a separate 5-mark question, thymus gland alone 5-mark question. It comes under immunology parts. One of the major endocrine gland, a major lymphoid organ, right? It is located in the upper part of the chest covering the lower end of the trachea. And the trachea bifurcate into two bronchi where you can find thymus. Now, it secretes a hormone called thymosin. So, thymosin is the hormone. Along with this hormone, it also secretes thymopoietin, thymulin. Other hormones also secreted from thymus gland. So, this is about its structure. When you see the diagram part, you can find it has got two lobes. See the lobe which is located here, left and right lobes. When you take the section of lobes, they are covered by the membrane called the capsule. And inside you can find the medulla part and outer part of the thymus is cortex. So cortex and medulla is nothing but it is the areas, regions of the structure. Then thymic corpuscles. Now, interior part of the thymus contain enormous amount of lymphocytes. Now, thymus, it plays very important role for the production of lymphocytes. Now, they are a function of thymosin alone given in your book. Now, what are the general functions of thymus? See, it has a stimulatory effect of the immune function. Stimulatory effect of immune function in the sense that it produces enormous number of lymphocytes. That lymphocytes come to the circulation which take part in cell mediated immunity. The cells which comes out from the thymus have got the ability to kill the pathogen directly. That is called cell mediated immunity. They devour the pathogen and then kill it. That is the meaning of cell mediated immunity. It stimulates the production and differentiation of lymphocytes. So this is production of lymphocyte, I told you. Some of the lymphocytes which are formed from lymph node get educated from the thymus and then come to the circulation and they acquire immunological competencies. They can easily find the pathogen and devour it and kill it. So So that is called immunological competency, we can say. That is why the second point, it stimulates the production and differentiation of lymphocyte, that is given. So it's about the functions of thymus gland. So thymus gland act as both endocrine as well as lymphoid organ. So with that, thymus gland is over. So far, we have completed all the endocrine glands. So human endocrine glands we have studied, pituitary gland, thyroid gland, parathyroid gland, pancreas, islets of Langerhans gland, adrenal gland. In the adrenal gland, we have seen adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. Then it is followed by gonads, testes and ovary. And last, we have studied about thymus gland. Right. From Monday onwards, you will have some general instruction. From Monday onwards, your classes will start from 6 p.m. So, in this week we have started class exactly at 5 p.m. Coming Monday onwards, you will have regular class, online classes starting from 6 p.m. onwards. So, not at the 5 p.m. So, small changes from our administrative side. Right. The questions which are given in your book, go through that. Even the assignment I will upload in your regular classes. Then go through the assignment which is given by our administrative side and go through, have a time for 4 or 5 days and then submit the assignment into the center. Right. Thank you all.